Welcome to our online March Gladness Spring Revival 2022 worship experience. Now, here are our upcoming announcements.
To help combat the COVID-19 coronavirus outbreak, Alfred Street Baptist Church has suspended all in-person worship services, activities, and events until further notice. We know that these are difficult and challenging times. We invite you to stay connected by participating in our online worship services and remain faithful in your giving online via our Alfred Street website, ASBC app, and on our text messaging system. If you have any questions about giving, please feel free to email our finance department at finance@alfordstreet.org. If you're interested in becoming a member of the historic Alfred Street Baptist Church, please email deacons with an S at alfordstreet.org or complete the membership form on our website or on our ASBC app.
Our Christian Life Institute, also known as CLI, and Christian Education present Finding and Keeping Your Joy, an online Zoom experience open to everyone on Thursday, March 17th, starting at 7 p.m. Eastern Time. If you're looking for joy in your life, we invite everyone to join Reverend Dr. Latasha Morgan and learn how to be joyful in whatever life may bring your way. Be sure to register online today. Our Career Development Ministry presents Where Are You in 2022? Part 1, Unlocking Your Greatness, on Thursday, March 31st, starting at 7 p.m. Eastern Time. Be sure to register online today. Hey, Alfred Street, Versus is back in stock. Our Versus team has been working around the clock to create another batch of our popular Versus Bible-based trivia card game, and they're now available for purchase. That's right, purchase your set of Versus cards today before we sell out again. Visit our website or ASBC app and be the first to get your hands on Versus, a Bible-based trivia game by Alfred Street Baptist Church. What better way to spark meaningful conversations while also gaining knowledge of the Word of God? Versus is packed with questions about animals, kingship, parables, miracles, and much more. Versus is the perfect way to bring your family together while also helping to grow the ministry of Alfred Street Baptist Church. It includes 150 trivia cards in a handy compact box set.
Hey, Alfred Street family and friends. Are you visiting us for the very first time? Or perhaps you're new to Alfred Street and you want to stay connected to us or receive the latest Alfred Street updates via text. If so, all visitors, text the word visitors with an S to our new direct text number, 571-977-4525. That's 571-977-4525. Or if you're not a new visitor, but you want to receive the latest Alfred Street updates via text, please text the words ASBC News, that's ASBC News, no space between ASBC and News, to that same direct number, 571-977-4525. Again, text ASBC News to 571-977-4525, and you'll receive the latest Alfred Street updates about upcoming events and activities. Please note that data rates may apply, so please check with your phone carriers. We thank you in advance for worshiping with us virtually.
Hey, Alfred Street. Speaking of new things, our intercessory prayer ministry is introducing an ASBC prayer wall for 2022. It's praying time, so this ASBC prayer wall will be accessible 24 hours a day online. Visit our website and or ASBC app for more info. You can also email prayer at alfredstreet.org for additional information.
We invite everyone to continue to join your Alfred Street ministers and family Monday through Friday for our popular 7 a.m. Eastern Time prayer call. Join us in prayer and praise Monday through Friday only by dialing 425-436-6277, access code 246-114 pound sign. Again, that's 425-436-6277, access code 246-114 pound sign. Our new prayer line number will accommodate up to 2,000 participants. However, once we reach capacity, we will continue to offer the playback option. Call our playback number anytime after 7:30 a.m. Eastern Time each day, Monday through Friday, and you'll be able to replay the prayer call that you missed. To reach the playback line, please dial 425-436-6278 and enter the access code 246114 pound sign. Please note that this is not a toll-free number and therefore, depending on your phone carrier, rates may apply.
Pastor Wesley's pick for the March Book of the Month is Learning to Walk in the Dark by New York Times bestselling author Barbara Brown Taylor. This book examines how we can find coverage through darkness and understand the world in new ways. We feel God's presence around us, guiding us through things seen and unseen. This book provides a way to find spirituality in those times when we don't have all the answers. It's time to put aside our fears and anxieties and explore all that God has to teach us in the dark. Be sure to pick up a copy from your favorite retailer. Our Office of Christian Care and Counseling would like to share that March is the time to learn more about self-harm, self-injury. Self-harm is often a response to anxiety or depression where a person inflicts harm, injury, danger, or pain on themselves. Self-harm, self-injury is an effort to alleviate and release emotions and feelings. Be sure to visit our website and or our virtual events page for recommended scriptures, resources, as well as helpful tools and links regarding self-harm and self-injury. For additional assistance, email pastoralcounseling at alfredstreet.org.
Kid Street, Crossover and Higher Ground are back in session at 11:30 a.m. Eastern Standard Time on the 1st, 3rd, 4th, and 5th Sundays. Parents, grandparents, aunts and uncles, and or guardians, please make sure that you've registered your child or children to receive the most up-to-date information on all children and youth programmatic offerings. Alfred Street's Men's Ministry invites all men to join us virtually for weekly Men's Sunday School. Email men at alfredstreet.org to receive the Zoom virtual classroom information. Also, we invite you to tune in to our Faith Forward weekly radio broadcast featuring Pastor Howard John Wesley every Sunday morning at 7:30 a.m. Eastern Standard Time on Magic 102.3 FM and 92.7 FM for a powerful sermon that will move you forward in your faith.
For more information on these and all the exciting events taking place here at Alfred Street, please log on to alfredstreet.org. Welcome to our online March Gladness Spring Revival 2022 worship experience. Now, here are our upcoming announcements.
To help combat the COVID-19 coronavirus outbreak, Alfred Street Baptist Church has suspended all in-person worship services, activities, and events until further notice. We know that these are difficult and challenging times. We invite you to stay connected by participating in our online worship services and remain faithful in your giving online via our Alfred Street website, ASBC app, and on our text messaging system. If you have any questions about giving, please feel free to email our finance department at finance@alfredstreet.org. If you're interested in becoming a member of the historic Alfred Street Baptist Church, please email deacons with an S at alfredstreet.org or complete the membership form on our website or on our ASBC app.
Our Christian Life Institute, also known as CLI, and Christian Education present Finding and Keeping Your Joy, an online Zoom experience open to everyone on Thursday, March 17th, starting at 7 p.m. Eastern Time. If you're looking for joy in your life, we invite everyone to join Reverend Dr. Latasha Morgan and learn how to be joyful in whatever life may bring your way. Be sure to register online today. Our Career Development Ministry presents Where Are You in 2022? Part 1, Unlocking Your Greatness, on Thursday, March 31st, starting at 7 p.m. Eastern Time. Be sure to register online today. Hey, Alfred Street, Verses is back in stock. Our Verses team has been working around the clock to create another batch of our popular Verses Bible-based trivia card game, and they're now available for purchase. That's right, purchase your set of Verses cards today before we sell out again. Visit our website or ASBC app and be the first to get your hands on Verses, a Bible-based trivia game by Alfred Street Baptist Church. What better way to spark meaningful conversations while also gaining knowledge of the Word of God? Verses is packed with questions about animals, kingship, parables, miracles, and much more. Verses is the perfect way to bring your family together while also helping to grow the ministry of Alfred Street Baptist Church. It includes 150 trivia cards in a handy compact box set.
Hey, Alfred Street family and friends. Are you visiting us for the very first time? Or perhaps you're new to Alfred Street and you want to stay connected to us or receive the latest Alfred Street updates via text? If so, all visitors, text the word visitors with an S to our new direct text number, 571-977-4525. That's 571-977-4525. Or if you're not a new visitor, but you want to receive the latest Alfred Street updates via text, please text the words ASBC News. That's ASBC News, no space between ASBC and News, to that same direct number, 571-977-4525. Again, text ASBC News to 571-977-4525, and you'll receive the latest Alfred Street updates about upcoming events and activities. Please note that data rates may apply, so please check with your phone carriers. We thank you in advance for worshiping with us virtually.
Hey, Alfred Street, speaking of new things, our intercessory prayer ministry is introducing an ASBC prayer wall for 2022. It's praying time, so this ASBC prayer wall will be accessible 24 hours a day online. Visit our website and or ASBC app for more info. You can also email prayer at alfredstreet.org for additional information.
We invite everyone to continue to join your Alfred Street ministers and family Monday through Friday for our popular 7 a.m. Eastern Time prayer call. Join us in prayer and praise Monday through Friday only by dialing 425-436-6277, access code 246-114 pound sign. Again, that's 425-436-6277, access code 246-114 pound sign. Our new prayer line number will accommodate up to 2,000 participants. However, once we reach capacity, we will continue to offer the playback option. Call our playback number anytime after 7:30 a.m. Eastern Time each day, Monday through Friday, and you'll be able to replay the prayer call that you missed. To reach the playback line, please dial 425-436-6278 and enter the access code 246-114 pound sign. Please note that this is not a toll-free number, and therefore, depending on your phone carrier, rates may apply.
Pastor Wesley's pick for the March Book of the Month is Learning to Walk in the Dark by New York Times bestselling author Barbara Brown Taylor. This book examines how we can find coverage through darkness and understand the world in new ways. We feel God's presence around us, guiding us through things seen and unseen. This book provides a way to find spirituality in those times when we don't have all the answers. It's time to put aside our fears and anxieties and explore all that God has to teach us in the dark. Be sure to pick up a copy from your favorite retailer. Our Office of Christian Care and Counseling would like to share that March is the time to learn more about self-harm, self-injury. Self-harm is often a response to anxiety or depression where a person inflicts harm, injury, danger, or pain on themselves. Self-harm, self-injury is an effort to alleviate and release emotions and feelings. Be sure to visit our website and or our virtual events page for recommended scriptures, resources, as well as helpful tools and links regarding self-harm and self-injury. For additional assistance, email pastoralcounseling at alfredstreet.org.
Kid Street, crossover at Higher Ground, are back in session at 11:30 a.m. Eastern Standard Time on the 1st, 3rd, 4th, and 5th Sundays. Parents, grandparents, aunts and uncles, and or guardians, please make sure that you've registered your child or children to receive the most up-to-date information on all children and youth programmatic offerings. Alfred Street's Men's Ministry invites all men to join us virtually for weekly Men's Sunday School. Email men at alfredstreet.org to receive the Zoom virtual classroom information. Also, we invite you to tune in to our Faith Forward weekly radio broadcast featuring Pastor Howard John Wesley every Sunday morning at 7:30 a.m. Eastern Standard Time on Magic 102.3 FM and 92.7 FM for a powerful sermon that will move you forward in your faith.
For more information on these and all the exciting events taking place here at Alfred Street, please log on to alfredstreet.org. Welcome to our online March Gladness Spring Revival 2022 worship experience. Now, here are our upcoming announcements.
To help combat the COVID-19 coronavirus outbreak, Alfred Street Baptist Church has suspended all in-person worship services, activities, and events until further notice. We know that these are difficult and challenging times. We invite you to stay connected by participating in our online worship services and remain faithful in your giving online via our Alfred Street website, ASBC app, and on our text messaging system. If you have any questions about giving, please feel free to email our finance department at finance@alfordstreet.org. If you're interested in becoming a member of the historic Alfred Street Baptist Church, please email deacons with an S at alfordstreet.org or complete the membership form on our website or on our ASBC app.
Our Christian Life Institute, also known as CLI, and Christian Education present Finding and Keeping Your Joy, an online Zoom experience open to everyone on Thursday, March 17th, starting at 7 p.m. Eastern Time. If you're looking for joy in your life, we invite everyone to join Reverend Dr. Latasha Morgan and learn how to be joyful in whatever life may bring your way. Be sure to register online today. Our Career Development Ministry presents Where Are You in 2022? Part 1, Unlocking Your Greatness, on Thursday, March 31st, starting at 7 p.m. Eastern Time. Be sure to register online today. Hey, Alfred Street, Verses is back in stock. Our Verses team has been working around the clock to create another batch of our popular Verses Bible-based trivia card game, and they're now available for purchase. That's right, purchase your set of Verses cards today before we sell out again. Visit our website or ASBC app and be the first to get your hands on Verses, a Bible-based trivia game by Alfred Street Baptist Church. What better way to spark meaningful conversations while also gaining knowledge of the Word of God? Verses is packed with questions about animals, kingship, parables, miracles, and much more. Verses is the perfect way to bring your family together while also helping to grow the ministry of Alfred Street Baptist Church. It includes 150 trivia cards in a handy compact box set.
Hey, Alfred Street family and friends, are you visiting us for the very first time? Or perhaps you're new to Alfred Street and you want to stay connected to us or receive the latest Alfred Street updates via text. If so, all visitors, text the word visitors with an S to our new direct text number, 571-977-4525. That's 571-977-4525. Or if you're not a new visitor, but you want to receive the latest Alfred Street updates via text, please text the words ASBC News, that's ASBC News, no space between ASBC and News, to that same direct number, 571-977-4525. Again, text ASBC News to 571-977-4525, and you'll receive the latest Alfred Street updates about upcoming events and activities. Please note that data rates may apply, so please check with your phone carriers. We thank you in advance for worshiping with us virtually.
Hey, Alfred Street. Speaking of new things, our intercessory prayer ministry is introducing an ASBC prayer wall for 2022. It's praying time, so this ASBC prayer wall will be accessible 24 hours a day online. Visit our website and or ASBC app for more info. You can also email prayer@alfredstreet.org for additional information.
We invite everyone to continue to join your Alfred Street ministers and family Monday through Friday for our popular 7 a.m. Eastern Time prayer call. Join us in prayer and praise Monday through Friday only by dialing 425-436-6277, access code 246-114#. Again, that's 425-436-6277, access code 246-114#. Our new prayer line number will accommodate up to 2,000 participants. However, once we reach capacity, we will continue to offer the playback option. Call our playback number anytime after 7:30 a.m. Eastern Time each day, Monday through Friday, and you'll be able to replay the prayer call that you missed. To reach the playback line, please dial 425-436-6278 and enter the access code 246-114#. Please note that this is not a toll-free number, and therefore, depending on your phone carrier, rates may apply.
Pastor Wesley's pick for the March Book of the Month is Learning to Walk in the Dark by New York Times bestselling author Barbara Brown Taylor. This book examines how we can find coverage through darkness and understand the world in new ways. We feel God's presence around us, guiding us through things seen and unseen. This book provides a way to find spirituality in those times when we don't have all the answers. It's time to put aside our fears and anxieties and explore all that God has to teach us in the dark. Be sure to pick up a copy from your favorite retailer.
We invite everyone to continue to join your Alfred Street ministers and family Monday through Friday for our popular 7 a.m. Eastern Time prayer call. Join us in prayer and praise Monday through Friday only by dialing 425-436-6277, access code 246-114#. Again, that's 425-436-6277, access code 246-114#. Our new prayer line number will accommodate up to 2,000 participants. However, once we reach capacity, we will continue to offer the playback option. Call our playback number anytime after 7:30 a.m. Eastern Time each day, Monday through Friday, and you'll be able to replay the prayer call that you missed. To reach the playback line, please dial 425-436-6278 and enter the access code 246-114#. Please note that this is not a toll-free number, and therefore, depending on your phone carrier, rates may apply.
Pastor Wesley's pick for the March Book of the Month is Learning to Walk in the Dark by New York Times bestselling author Barbara Brown Taylor. Be sure to pick up a copy from your favorite retailer. Our Office of Christian Care and Counseling would like to share that March is the time to learn more about self-harm, self-injury. For additional assistance, email pastoralcounseling@alfordstreet.org.
Kid Street, Crossover at Higher Ground are back in session at 11:30 a.m. Eastern Standard Time on the 1st, 3rd, 4th, and 5th Sundays. Parents, grandparents, aunts and uncles, and all guardians, please make sure that you've registered your child or children to receive the most up-to-date information on all children and youth programmatic offerings. Alfred Street's Men's Ministry invites all men to join us virtually for weekly Men's Sunday School. Email men@alfordstreet.org to receive the Zoom virtual classroom information. Also, we invite you to tune in to our Faith Forward weekly radio broadcast featuring Pastor Howard John Wesley every Sunday morning at 7:30 a.m. Eastern Standard Time on Magic 102.3 FM and 92.7 FM for a powerful sermon that will move you forward in your faith.
For more information on these and all the exciting events taking place here at Alfred Street, please log on to alfordstreet.org.
Thank you. Greetings, Alpha Street, and welcome to online worship and March Gladness. I was telling some of the team here that it's been so long since I have been in the midst of live worship, but I will tell you this. I was glad when they said unto me, "Let us go into the house of the Lord." We are here to celebrate March Gladness and be revived because we sought the Lord in January and we emptied ourselves out. It is time for a revival. So I am glad to be here with you in the midst of March Gladness, and I cannot wait to feast on the worship and the word. Let us pray. Lord, we come to you and we are grateful, Lord God, for your presence. We're thankful, Lord God, that you have been with us all day, all night, Lord God, because you never sleep nor slumber. We pray, God, over this worship experience, that you will be in the midst of it, that you will be pleased with it. It is in the name of Jesus we pray. Amen.
Praise the Lord, everybody. This song that we're going to open up with is really a prayer. So if you've been praying since January, we're going to allow you to just continue in prayer, even singing this song as a prayer. It simply says, "Be glorified." If you've been praying, that should be your heart's cry, that God would be glorified.
Be glorified. Be glorified. Help me say, be glorified. God, we want you to be.
Peace. Jesus, be thou glorified. Hallelujah. Come on, let's continue to worship our Father in spirit and in truth. And even though we want him to be glorified, there are times when we're just weak. But the word says clearly that his strength is made perfect in our weakness. And so we celebrate that in this simple song. You are my strength, strength like no other, strength like no other reaches to me. You are my hope, hope like no other, hope like no other reaches to me. Can you help me say that? Come on.
You are my strength.
Strength like no other.
Strength like no other.
You are my strength.
Strength like no other.
Reaches
to me.
When I'm hopeless, you are.
You are. Stronger than mountains.
reaches.
Confused, it reaches.
Right when I'm hurt, right when I'm down, it reaches. You've gone too far, don't worry, because it reaches. If you feel you're lost, it reaches. Just call on the name of Jesus. Call on the name of Jesus. His love, it reaches. It reaches. If you think you've gone too far, don't worry, because it reaches to me.
For the joy of the Lord is our strength, and the Lord is our light and our salvation. Whom shall we fear? For the Lord is the strength of our life. And whom shall we be afraid? Thank you, Psalms of Praise, for that song that resonates well within our hearts. Tonight's scripture will be Psalm 100, and it's one of my favorites. Make a joyful shout to the Lord, all you lands. Serve the Lord with gladness. Come before his presence with singing. Know that the Lord, he is God. It is he who has made us and not we ourselves. We are his people and the sheep of his pasture. Enter into his gates with thanksgiving and into his courts with praise. Be thankful unto him and bless his name. For the Lord is good. His mercy is everlasting and his truth endures to all generations. Join us in our hymn of rejoicing, Nothing But the Blood. For it is nothing but the blood that gives us our salvation and the assurance of eternal life. Sing with us right now.
Nothing.
Alpha Street, it is giving time. And I, for one, can vouch for this branch of Zion, that when you sow into this place, you are sowing into good soil. So when you give unto us, we give it back to the Lord and we give it back to the community. At least 10% of what you give us goes back out into the community. We are feeding people. We are clothing people. We are keeping shelter above people's heads. So give what your heart desires, what your heart is telling you to give, because that is the Holy Spirit that is talking to you, and He has a plan for what you are about to give. Don't give sparingly, give joyfully, because God has a plan for you and God has a plan for this place. Let us pray. God, we're thankful what you have given us. We pray, Lord God, for provisions for those that we are serving. We pray, God, for the provisions of those who are giving. We pray, God, for those who are not able to give, but would love to do so. Bless their houses. Bless them richly, Lord God. And as we are receiving of those gifts, God, may we be great stewards over what you have given us to do. Cast your vision, and may we carry it like a herald all through these streets. It is in the name of Jesus we pray. Amen.
Hey, beloved, grace and peace be unto you from God who loves us as a father and a mother, and Jesus Christ who alone is our resurrected, our risen, our reigning, and our returning Redeemer. On this Tuesday evening, I'm grateful to God not only for God sparing us through another day's journey, but gathering us together in this virtual worship space. You all know that we gather here every Tuesday in March to celebrate the resurrection of Jesus Christ and to be fed with the word of God from on high. Listen, I want to clue you in into a little secret. Someone asked me this week, Pastor, how do you choose the preachers for March Gladness? Y'all, I wish I could tell you that I laid out an anointing and prayer and fasting for 40 days and the Lord discerned it and I got it in a dream and the Lord put them on my mind. Yeah, that's not really how it happens. You wanna know how it happens? I love good preaching. I love to hear good preaching, and I always want to bring the best preachers we can here to Alpha Street Baptist Church. Tonight, it's real simple. We've got one of the best preachers in the nation, one of my favorite preachers in the kingdom of Christ, Reverend Dr. John Faison, the senior pastor of the Watson Grove Baptist Church in Tennessee. He's been with us multiple times before, and he's back for one simple reason. The man can flat out tell the truth of the good news of Jesus Christ. So as we enter into worship, let's get our hearts and our minds ready that we might receive a word from the Lord and that God might be enriched and enlivened through the way that we give him glory and praise on tonight. Let's get ready to worship him in spirit and in truth.
Oh, Grace and peace be multiplied unto you in the name of God our Father and his Son, Jesus the Christ. It is my joy to come to you in this virtual sanctuary to declare that there is a word from the Lord. What an honor and a privilege it is to be a part of this March Gladness Revival. Please help me to celebrate, appreciate, and to honor the pastor of this people and the angel of this assembly, my friend and my brother, Reverend Dr. Howard John Wesley. So grateful for his kind invitation to come share in this space at the Alfred Street Church and with the Alfred Street Online virtual community. I cannot tell you how important it is for us in these moments to not lose sight of the renewing power of the Spirit. And so I celebrate and appreciate the concept and idea of revival even in this space, because we need to be led and refreshed by God's Spirit. In that way, let's dive into the word. Go with me in your Bibles to the book of Nehemiah. Nehemiah chapter 2, beginning at verse 16. I'm going to read to verse 20. Nehemiah chapter 2, verses 16 through 20. Reading from the New Living Translation, here's what the word says. The city officials did not know I had been out there or what I was doing, for I had not yet said anything to anyone about my plans. I had not yet spoken to the Jewish leaders, the priests, the nobles, the officials, or anyone else in the administration. But now I said to them, you know very well what trouble we are in. Jerusalem lies in ruins, and its gates have been destroyed by fire. Let us rebuild the wall of Jerusalem and end this disgrace. Then I told them about how the gracious hand of God had been on me and about my conversation with the king. They replied at once, yes, let's rebuild the wall. So they began the good work. But when Sanballat, Tobiah, and Geshem, the Arab, heard of our plan, they scoffed contemptuously. What are you doing? Are you rebelling against the king? They asked. I replied, the God of heaven will help us succeed. We, his servants, will start rebuilding this wall. But you have no share, legal right, or historic claim in Jerusalem. This is the word of the Lord. Might the people of God say, amen. I want to share today the Holy Spirit's guidance with your prayers from the subject, I don't want it, but I need it. I don't want it, but I need it. Let's bow. God, thank you for this day. Thank you for life, health, and strength. Thank you for this wonderful chance that we have to gather in worship and in your word. It's our prayer now, Lord, that you'll let the words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart allow it to be acceptable in your sight, O Lord, my strength and my redeemer. God, preach through me, to me, and for me. Send a word so your people are edified, but in all things, it's your name that receives the glory. I bless you for the treasure that you've placed in earthen vessels, that the excellency of the power may be of God and not of us. We pray it and ask it. In Jesus' name, amen. I don't want it, but I need it. Beloved, I believe unequivocally that God has called each and every one of us to greatness. I say that without hesitation and without fear of contradiction, that each and every one of us who are products of the gracious hand of God are called to a level of greatness. For me, that makes sense because a great God would never call us to anything less than greatness. And beloved, the story of Nehemiah is a wonderful glimpse into what that process can look like. And it's a story I believe we all ought to be paying attention to. Nehemiah, of course, is a story of a leader who comes together to help rebuild the wall of Jerusalem. But we often get stuck on the destination of the rebuilt wall, that it's real easy to miss the journey on the way. But the journey that Nehemiah undergoes is really what I believe speaks to us in helping us to understand the pathway to greatness. See, the story of God leading Nehemiah begins in chapter 1. It is that vision, again, to rebuild the walls of Jerusalem. And that was important because the walls of a city in that day really signified security for that city. It was a psychological witness to help them understand their sovereignty, their safety, and their protection. But with the walls being burned down and torn down, they felt violated. Their borders could be breached at any given time. So he gets a vision. After he hears the news of what's happening in Jerusalem, he gets a vision to rebuild the wall. But the purpose of Nehemiah's leadership in this moment was bigger than just wall building. It was really about reestablishing community. It was really about really creating and recreating this space of sanctity and connection to God for the city of Jerusalem. The wall was the instrument, but community was the intention. And so God leads Nehemiah in chapter 1. But the story of Nehemiah leading others actually begins in chapter 2. In chapter 2, we read verses 16 through 20. And in verses 16 through 18, Nehemiah shares his vision with the leaders of the city and God's help, how God has already been proactive in setting this goal and making it possible. But in verses 19 through 20, we get introduced to some opponents of the vision, if you will. They are Sanballat, Tobiah, and Geshem. I want to argue tonight that the turning point in Nehemiah's journey to fulfill God's call happens right here. This is where he transitions from private visionary now to public leader. Because public leadership, beloved, does not begin until people are involved and problems begin to arise. This is where I want to park tonight, because it's really cute for you and I to believe that we will have universal support when we start walking out the plans that God has given you and I to impact our community. It's real nice. It's real cute for us to believe that everybody's going to be 100% on board with the efforts to reestablish that which God is calling us to impact our communities and to rebuild the walls that have been torn down in our society. But that's simply not the reality of the world in which we live. I want you to know there is no leadership without the presence of opposition. Did you hear what I said? I said there's no such thing as leadership without the presence of opposition. Communities are never constructed and certainly not reconstructed without some type of resistance. And I want you to know, opposition, beloved, as you pursue the purpose and the plan God has for your life, opposition is not some pesky detail you can avoid. Opposition, beloved, is the mandatory down payment for doing transformative work in this world. It's not a factor to be eliminated. It's actually a reality to be embraced. That's why opposition is the burden we don't want, but it's the blessing we absolutely need. Opposition, you might not want it, but if we're honest, we actually need it. Think about it. In terms of Nehemiah, look at how God has moved heaven and earth for Nehemiah thus far by the time we get to chapter 2 and verse 16. Here's what has happened. God has given him the vision and the passion to rebuild the walls of Jerusalem. God has given him favor with King Artaxerxes, his boss, and given him path and safe passage to start the work. God has gotten him letters that guarantee his safe passage to and from Jerusalem. God has given him materials to rebuild the wall and his own dwelling financed by the king. God got him armed security escorts for the length of his entire stay. God gave him influence with the Jerusalem leaders so they bought into his vision. Here's my question. If God has removed all of these barriers for Nehemiah, then why, when Sanballat, Tobiah, and Geshem show up, why doesn't God just remove them too? If God's done all this work, set the stage, ordered his steps, given him favor and access to begin the process, then why, when Sanballat, Tobiah, and Geshem, the forms of opposition show up, why didn't God just simply remove them too? Maybe it's because God knows something about opposition that you and I better learn. And that is that opposition is a great tool that God often uses to help make us our best for God. That might be the reason why God didn't remove opposition from Nehemiah's life, and perhaps it might be the reason why God won't take it from ours. Oh, I know you've been praying, God, get this out of my way. I know you've been requesting with your specific prayer Christmas list, please remove this obstacle and this opposition. God, if you just let me get past this and get this out the way, I can handle it. I know you're praying and asking God to remove the opposition. But beloved, I was sent to tell you today, opposition is the burden you don't want, but it's the blessing you absolutely need. Your strongest spiritual muscles are built in the gymnasium of opposition. Your greatest levels of patience come from having to sit in the waiting room of adversity. The greatest pictures of you and I walking in purpose are always developed in the dark room of resistance. Opposition is a burden we don't want, but it's a blessing that we absolutely need. And when we embrace this reality, suddenly we become empowered to see opposition in a brand new way. And beloved, I just want you to take a few moments with me tonight, dive through the passage, walk through Nehemiah chapter 2, and maybe you'll see and walk away saying, I don't want it, but I need it. I didn't ask for it. I didn't sign up for it. I didn't anticipate this level of opposition happening. But if I'm going to do what God has called me to do, I got to embrace it as the price of admission. And ultimately, there's something that opposition's going to do for me. I want to offer you some things that opposition does that are absolutely necessary for you and I. Y'all interested tonight? Here's what we see in Nehemiah. We need opposition, number one, because opposition tests the integrity of our motives. I say you need opposition because opposition tests the integrity of our motives. Beloved, opposition makes us clarify the reason behind what we're doing. Why you are doing something can only be validated when what you are doing gets hard. Why you are standing, why you are working in this direction really only gets confirmed when the what that you are doing becomes a bit difficult. Watch it in the passage. Up to this point, the path to rebuilding community has been paved with ease for Nehemiah. I told you, everything he's requested, he's been granted. Every step he's asked for, every moment he's needed, he's been funded and subsidized and supported. Nehemiah knows that he is working for the good of the people of Jerusalem. But he can only assume that the people he's working to help believe this. They have no evidence that Nehemiah is all in. They have no evidence that Nehemiah is all in for them. Nor do they have evidence that he's all in for God. They just met him. They don't know. That is, until Sanballat, Tobiah, and Geshem show up. And now the presence of opposition makes Nehemiah defend and prove that he's all in. And Nehemiah's commitment in the face of opposition now becomes the best evidence that his motives are in the right place. See, when things get hard, if you're not really serious about why you're doing it, you will change what you're doing. But when opposition comes, it makes us really dig deep to the core of who we are and really figure out, do I want to go this way? And am I willing to bear the brunt of attack in order to accomplish it? You say you want progress, but you don't know you want it until you got to pay a price for it. Opposition tests the integrity of our motives. Can I help you today? This is why you got to stop avoiding the opposition in your life. I would even argue that you need to stop asking God to to take it away. Because what you don't realize is that your response in the midst of the opposition is the way that God is going to prove to the world that you can be trusted. It is the opposition that is coming your way that is going to show you are fully committed to what you've committed to. It's the opposition and the obstacles in your way that are really going to prove to the world that you can be trusted with the level of leadership you've been assigned. Why would you push away the thing that's going to validate God's presence on your leadership? I don't want it, but I need it. I need it because opposition tests the integrity of my motives. But here's what else opposition does. Opposition number two also displays the impact of our mission. Got to have opposition because it displays the impact of our mission. See, sometimes the powerful way opposition shows up to stop your purpose actually reveals just how powerful your purpose really is. The presence of opposition in our lives proves often that we're doing something that really matters. And when you walk in purpose, when you are committed to that which God has directed you to, everything about your opposition becomes a revelation. Everything about the things and even the people that are lined up diametrically opposed to where God is taking you begin to show you some things about where God is taking you. Watch what happens in the text. Pay attention, if you will, to Nehemiah's opposition. Watch when they show up. Do you have your Bible? You need your Bible. Verse 18, Bible says this. So they began the good work. This is Nehemiah and the leaders and those in Jerusalem. Bible says, verse 18, they began the work, good work. Verse 19, Bible says, Sanballat, Tobiah, and Geshem show up. Don't miss that. Verse 18, they start to do what they believe God is leading them to do. They begin the work of restoring Jerusalem's walls and reestablishing the community in that space. And the moment they began the good work, the next verse says, then Sanballat, Tobiah, and Geshem show up. Notice, as soon as progress begins, problems arise. Could it be that the problems that arise are then indicators that progress is happening? Might I suggest to you that if there are no problems, it usually means there is no progress. Because obstacles don't show up in the way of persons or entities that are not making progress or making a difference. Let me help you. The enemy, often we give too much credit to. Some call him the devil, some call him Satan. I'll call him the enemy for the sake of our conversation today. The enemy is not God. God has enemies, but God does not have equals. God is omnipotent. The enemy is not. God is omniscient. The enemy is not. God is omnipotent. The enemy is not. So because the enemy does not have the capacity that God has, the enemy has to leverage and use his resources in spaces that give him the most bang for his buck. So the enemy doesn't attack anything that doesn't threaten him. So when problems begin to arise on your pathway to purpose, you ought to get excited when they show up, not discouraged. Because problems arising are indication that progress has begun. You got to pay attention to when they show up, but you also got to pay attention to who they are. Walk with me for a few moments through the passage, because we get introduced to three enemies of progress in Jerusalem. Their names are Sanballat, Tobiah, and Geshem. And we often read those names and not really pay much attention to them, but I want to introduce to you who they are. Sanballat, beloved, is the governor of Samaria. He's the governor of a neighboring country, neighboring land, and he's been able to, with the walls torn down, been able to leverage Jerusalem for his own political benefit. He's been able to pass and sojourn to and from Jerusalem and leverage its resources for his own benefit.
But when Nehemiah begins to raise these walls again, Nehemiah's plans threaten his political authority. So naturally, he's going to be upset when the walls go up in Jerusalem, because now he doesn't have free access and free pass like he used to have. Sanballat is not the only enemy. Tobiah is an enemy as well. And Tobiah is a governor of Transjordan. Please don't miss the fact that two of the three people upset about Nehemiah's plans to rebuild the wall were politicians. Don't miss the fact that they have been leveraging Jerusalem for their own benefit and for their own good. Tobiah is the governor of Transjordan, and Nehemiah's plans threaten also his political influence. With the walls torn down, Tobiah and Sanballat, they can switch polling places and put them in places where brown and black folk won't be able to vote. Sanballat and Tobiah, with the walls torn down, can leverage resources and put schools in certain places that won't be beneficial for those at the bottom of the socioeconomic totem pole, but only be a blessing to those at the top. With the walls torn down, Sanballat and Tobiah can leverage their reach and control over Jerusalem. But if the walls go up, now Jerusalem becomes geographically sovereign again, and their political influence and authority are cut. So naturally, they're upset. But wait a minute, there's a third enemy here. It's not just Sanballat, Tobiah, it's also Geshem. Matter of fact, scripture says Geshem the Arab. He's not a politician. Geshem is an Arabian leader with business ties to Jerusalem. He's a businessman. In fact, he's such a businessman that he owns and operates a lucrative spice trade. And that spice trade has routes that run very conveniently through Jerusalem. And with the walls torn down, Geshem doesn't have to pay any taxes on his exit and entry into Jerusalem. With the walls torn down, Geshem doesn't have to be fair and equitable in the distribution of his profits. With the walls torn down, Geshem can rob, pilfer, and steal from the resources of Jerusalem. But when the wall goes up, suddenly, he can't pass freely as he wants to. He can't charge an exorbitant interest on his spice trade in Jerusalem. He does not have financial control anymore. So naturally, Sanballat, Tobiah, and Geshem are angry about the walls. Please notice that all of the opposition to the walls have been benefiting from them being broken. So when the walls are rebuilt, naturally, they're going to fight against that process, that progress. And that is because every purpose that blesses someone is going to bother somebody else. Every time God's plan and purposes begin to be revealed and manifested in our lives, it'll bless some people, but it's going to bother others. And usually, it's going to bother the people who've been using the people you're trying to bless. It's going to irritate folks who have been mismanaging people, resources, and access for their own self-aggrandizement. But beloved, here's the lesson. This is why you got to thank God for the opposition in this season and in every season of your life. Because when opposition shows up, it means that the work you are doing is so powerful that it threatens those who don't want it done. It means that God is doing something so incredible in your life and is making such a tangible impact that it demands response from the enemy. Beloved, you ought to praise God every once in a while for the fact that your life is so important to God that it makes hell nervous. Every once in a while, you ought to praise God that what God has placed upon you is so vital and so special and so significant that the enemy got to send resources and reinforcements to make sure you don't walk in what God destined you to walk in. I don't want it, but I need it. I need it because opposition makes sure that I get the integrity of my motives tested. Opposition displays the impact of my mission. Here's the last one. Opposition, I need it because it uncovers the inadequacy of our humanity. I gotta have, you gotta have, we gotta have opposition because it reveals the inadequacy of our humanity. Beloved, let's be honest tonight. Opposition can be painful. It can catch us off guard. And it often comes from places you never expected it to come from. It's easy to expect opposition from people on the other side of where you're trying to go. But sometimes opposition comes from within. Sometimes opposition comes from unexpected places. It comes from people close. It comes from what you had perceived to be allies. And it's painful. It'll mess with your psyche. It'll mess with your spirit. But even that, even being caught off guard and knocked aback a bit by opposition, even that can be a blessing in disguise. Here's why. Because when we are hurt, caught off guard, and stunned by the presence of opposition, we actually become more aware of our own inadequacy. We actually become more aware of our own humanity. Suddenly, when opposition shows up, we get shocked into remembering that no matter how much power we think we have, we can't do this alone. So here's the danger of success and progress. Not only do you move forward, but it can make your head grow bigger. It can get us convinced of our own greatness. It can fool us into believing that we are responsible for our own advancement and our own promotion. But oh, nothing lessens the size of a big head. Nothing deflates pride and ego quite like dealing with an enemy you didn't expect. Nothing puts you back into the proper perspective and even the proper posture like having to deal with an enemy you couldn't account for. When opposition shows up, it reminds us of a very simple but fundamental truth. That is this. We need God. Beloved, this is a lesson. This is a lesson that Nehemiah learned early in the game. Watch what happens. As soon as his opposition shows themselves, Nehemiah leaned on the one who he knew was making all of this possible. Do you have your Bible? Verse 19, Bible says, Sanballat, Tobiah, and Geshem not only show up, but they begin to scoff at Nehemiah and the others. Listen to the sarcastic question they begin to ask. What are you doing, Nehemiah? Are you rebelling against the king? King? They are asking Nehemiah threateningly if he was rebelling against King Artaxerxes, his own boss, the guy he worked for as a cupbearer in Persia. What they don't know is that King Artaxerxes is actually funding the whole project. What they don't know is that King Artaxerxes has actually subsidized the journey and the building. Now, when his opposition shows up and tries to call him on the carpet about the king, it's real easy for Nehemiah to say, you think I'm trying to rebel against the king? Well, let me pull out my cell phone and call him and let you talk to him. Let me DM him on Twitter and let me get connected to him on Instagram and I'll show you that I've got the connections to get this done. I'll show you who I am and who I'm connected to and how much authority I'll have. I'll show you just who I am. But that's not what Nehemiah does. Nehemiah could reply easily about his connection to King Artaxerxes, but Nehemiah chooses to lean on his connection with another king. Do you have your Bible? Verse 20 says, Nehemiah replies to them, the God of heaven is going to help us. Nehemiah could easily have leaned on his associations and his network with the king, but instead he says, I'm going to go a little bit higher than that. My trust is not even in King Artaxerxes. My trust is in the God of heaven. My trust is in the God who built all of this. My trust is in the God of who these people actually belong to. And the presence of opposition has increased his reliance upon the God who begun the good work. Beloved, what if that's the reason why opposition in our lives sticks around longer than we want it to? What if that's why when we think opposition is gone and we've gotten past it and we're over it, it shows up again? Maybe that's why every time we surpass one level of opposition on one level of accomplishment and achievement, we get to another and another round begins. Could it be that God keeps opposition around so that we'll see we can't trust ourselves and we really do have to trust God? I wish you would tell the truth tonight. I mean, just for a few moments. I know you're watching at home. You're watching in your car. Maybe you're watching on your job. You're watching at the crib. And you don't really want to be honest, but I want to help you be honest today. Tell the truth. It was some of the opposition in your life that really made you know God better in the first place. Oh, I know. You love Jesus. You hang out with God all the time. You pray in tongues 14 times a day. I get it. You love God. But let's be honest for a moment. Some of the reasons we are deep in our relationship with God were not because of the calm and the placid seas we had to ride on with God. No, they were because of the stormy moments and the tornadoes and the hurricanes that came our way, often in the form of opposition. It was your opposition that made you pray more. It was your opposition that got you deep into the word because you realized churchy colloquialisms and slogans wouldn't hold you in the midst of attack. It was the opposition in your life that taught you how to love and taught you how to forgive and taught you how to move past faults and hurts. It was the opposition in our lives that made us a worshiper, taught us how to get at the feet of God and to stop seeking God's hand so much and to go after his face. It was opposition that took us there because opposition will uncover the inadequacy of our humanity. Beloved, here it is. I'm done. I don't want it. You don't want it either. But we all need it. We got to have opposition in our lives. And beloved, as I let you go, I got some good news and I got some bad news. I give you the bad news first. The bad news is that opposition will come and you can't get anything done without it. The bad news today is that I don't care what kind of progress you're trying to achieve. I don't care what kind of purpose you're trying to accomplish. I don't care what your goal is. If it's going to honor God and it's going to bless people, there will be opposition. And you can't get around it. You do God's work. You do work for God. You do God's will. And you can't do it without opposition. That's the bad news, but I got good news too. The good news is this: when opposition comes, though you can't work without it, it will work for you. That's the good news. That's the good news today, that regardless of how steep and dark and difficult that opposition might be, that opposition, if you are doing and working on the side of an almighty God, that work, that opposition will work for you. You don't want it. You don't ask for it. It's not on your prayer list, but it's exactly what you need. Don't just take Nehemiah for it, though. Jesus shows us the same thing, that it's the opposition that comes against you that actually helps to propel you to the place you're supposed to go. You know the story about Jesus. I don't have to rehash it all, but I'll give you cliff notes real quick. Christ does not go to the cross without opposition. Christ is not crucified and buried without opposition. Some opposition externally, some opposition internally, in his own circle. But God used the opposition to get him into purpose, to place him on the cross for our sins, to die and to save and give humanity an opportunity to be reclaimed and reconnected to an almighty God. And now that opposition has put him in a grave. 3 days later, because he followed the path that he needed to follow in the face of opposition, he is raised from the dead with all power in his hands. But not only is he have given power, Bible says he's also given a name that's above every name, that at the name of Jesus, every knee shall bow and every tongue shall confess that he is Lord to the glory of God the Father. So, beloved, I've learned how to thank God for my mountains. I've learned how to thank him for my valleys. I've learned how to thank God for the storms that he brought me through. If I never had a problem, I would never know that God could solve them. I'd never know what faith in God could do. But Andre Crouch said it best. Through it all, through every opposition and every obstacle, through every tragedy and every difficulty, I've learned to trust in Jesus. I've learned to trust in God. Through it all, I've learned to lean and depend upon his word. Loving it, it's not what you prayed for. It's not what you asked for. It is not on your dream sheet or your requests. You didn't put in a requisition for opposition. None of us asked for it. But it comes when you align yourself with the purpose God has designed. But you can be assured that all things will work together, opposition included, for the good of them that love the Lord and are called according to his purpose.
The gospel writer John shares with us that all the signs of Jesus were performed that we might believe that Jesus is the Son of God, and that by believing in him, we might have life in his name. John understands what I want to press to you today, that there's a difference between living and having life in the name of Jesus Christ. Your life has not reached its fullest in the here and now without Jesus. And you're not prepared for eternal life without believing in him and confessing in him as your Lord and Savior. And as a believer, as one who's confessed, it is critical that you be connected to a family of faith. If you're watching this broadcast today and you've never believed in Jesus Christ, you've never confessed that he was the Son of God, you've never opened with your mouth and said, I believe that he died and rose again, I want to share with you that there's life waiting for you that you haven't even imagined. If you are a believer, but in this season you found yourself detached from a local church home, our arms are open and welcome to you. Wherever you may be today, if you desire to know Christ better, if you desire to be part of this church family, wherever you may be in the World Wide Web, I'm going to encourage you to go out to our website. There's a link there that allows you to tell us about you, and we will reach right back out with you, to you to share with you the amazing life that awaits you, not just as a member of this church, but as a believer in Jesus Christ. So I pray that the Holy Spirit would guide you to join in with us, that together we might make glorious the name of Jesus Christ.
Welcome to our online Marked Gladness Spring Revival 2022 worship experience. Now, here are our upcoming announcements.
To help combat the COVID-19 coronavirus outbreak, Alfred Street Baptist Church has suspended all in-person worship services, activities, and events until further notice. We know that these are difficult and challenging times. We invite you to stay connected by participating in our online worship services and remain faithful in your giving online via our Alfred Street website, ASBC app, and on our text messaging system. If you have any questions about giving, please feel free to email our finance department at finance@alfordstreet.org. If you're interested in becoming a member of the historic Alfred Street Baptist Church, please email deacons with an S at alfordstreet.org or complete the membership form on our website or on our ASBC app.
Our Christian Life Institute, also known as CLI, and Christian Education present Finding and Keeping Your Joy, an online Zoom experience open to everyone on Thursday, March 17th, starting at 7 p.m. Eastern Time. If you're looking for joy in your life, we invite everyone to join Reverend Dr. Latasha Morgan and learn how to be joyful in whatever life may bring your way. Be sure to register online today. Our Career Development Ministry presents Where Are You in 2022? Part 1, Unlocking Your Greatness, on Thursday, March 31st, starting at 7 p.m. Eastern Time. Be sure to register online today. Hey, Alfred Street, Verses is back in stock. Our Verses team has been working around the clock to create another batch of our popular Verses Bible-based trivia card game, and they're now available for purchase. That's right, purchase your set of Verses cards today before we sell out again. Visit our website or ASBC app and be the first to get your hands on Verses, a Bible-based trivia game by Alfred Street Baptist Church.
Hey, Alfred Street family and friends. Are you visiting us for the very first time, or perhaps you're new to Alfred Street and you want to stay connected to us or receive the latest Alfred Street updates via text? If so, all visitors, text the word visitors with an S to our new direct text number, 571-977-4525. That's 571-977-4525. Or if you're not a new visitor, but you want to receive the latest Alfred Street updates via text, please text the words ASBC News, that's ASBC News, no space between ASBC and News, to that same direct number, 571-977-4525. Again, text ASBC News to 571-977-4525, and you'll receive the latest Alfred Street updates about upcoming events and activities. Please note that data rates may apply, so please check with your phone carriers. We thank you in advance for worshiping with us virtually.
Hey, Alfred Street. Speaking of new things, our intercessory prayer ministry is introducing an ASBC prayer wall for 2022. It's praying time, so this ASBC prayer wall will be accessible 24 hours a day online. Visit our website and or ASBC app for more info. You can also email prayer@alfordstreet.org for additional information.
We invite everyone to continue to join your Alfred Street ministers and family Monday through Friday for our popular 7 a.m. Eastern Time prayer call. Join us in prayer and praise Monday through Friday only by dialing 425-436-6277, access code 246-114#. Again, that's 425-436-6277, access code 246-114#. Our new prayer line number will accommodate up to 2,000 participants. However, once we reach capacity, we will continue to offer the playback option. Call our playback number anytime after 7:30 a.m. Eastern Time each day, Monday through Friday, and you'll be able to replay the prayer call that you missed. To reach the playback line, please dial 425-436-6278 and enter the access code 246-114#. Please note that this is not a toll-free number, and therefore, depending on your phone carrier, rates may apply.
Pastor Wesley's pick for the March Book of the Month is Learning to Walk in the Dark by New York Times bestselling author Barbara Brown Taylor. Be sure to pick up a copy from your favorite retailer. Our Office of Christian Care and Counseling would like to share that March is the time to learn more about self-harm, self-injury. For additional assistance, email pastoralcounseling@alfordstreet.org.
Kid Street, Crossover at Higher Ground are back in session at 11:30 a.m. Eastern Standard Time on the 1st, 3rd, 4th, and 5th Sundays. parents, grandparents, aunts and uncles, and all guardians, please make sure that you've registered your child or children to receive the most up-to-date information on all children and youth programmatic offerings. Alfred Street's Men's Ministry invites all men to join us virtually for weekly Men's Sunday School. Email men at alfredstreet.org to receive the Zoom virtual classroom information. Also, we invite you to tune in to our Faith Forward weekly radio broadcast featuring Pastor Howard John Wesley every Sunday morning at 7:30 a.m. Eastern Standard Time on Magic 102.3 FM and 92.7 FM for a powerful sermon that will move you forward in your faith.
For more information on these and all the exciting events taking place here at Alfred Street, please log on to alfredstreet.org.